Okay, so the following footage has been shot over about 6 months at various different restaurants in Windsor. I will provide links to their websites in the description below. The idea for this video is to give you, the consumer, an idea of perhaps where you could go to eat to get some decent food whilst you're in town. All of them focused on beef, so I apologise in advance if you're watching this and you're a vegetarian. But, you know, there's been a lot of steak and burger restaurants been opening up in Windsor. It's about time someone did a review of them that did them a justice. Sorry, I'm still recovering from a burger I ate. Did them justice, and B, gives you, the consumer, an idea as to where you'd like to go to have a meal. All right, without further ado, let's begin. So, the mighty quarter cheese. Looks appetizing. Unlike some of them, maybe a little too much ketchup. And now the moment of truth. Not bad. So there's a little bit too much ketchup on this burger. I've already had to wipe some off my mouth. But overall, nice tasting burger. So I've come to a more premium restaurant here in Windsor called the Cattle Grid. It's here inside the station. I've ordered some food. The waitress has interrupted by filming a couple of times already, but I'll be able to show you what we get in a moment. So this is their menu here. They do all sorts here. Garlic bread, half baby rack of ribs, buffalo wings, cow, which is what I've ordered. I've ordered a burger, which is on the next page. The brie and mature cheddar and bacon. They do pig, if you're into that. Sandwiches, salads, sides. Desserts, wine, a wide range of drinks, including ice cream and milkshakes. So this is what you get. That's a damn tasty burger, actually. Cheese, bacon, salad, tomato, onion. Kind of look forward to getting into this, actually.
All gone.
So that was my review of Cattle Grid. Very nice burger they do there. It's a little bit more expensive than the other premium burger joints in Windsor. I paid about £12 for what you saw. But I can heartily recommend it. It's a very good tasting burger. So whilst not strictly in Windsor, I've crossed the bridge over to Eton to come visit the Flaming Cow, which looks nice. I've never been here before. Let's go inside and see what we get. So I've ordered a double cheeseburger, well done, with some fries, and I'm going to see what it looks like when it comes out. Stay tuned. Wow, would you look at this? This looks nice. French fries. Lettuce that actually, oh, it is leafy. Oh, well. All gone. Really nice. So I wanted to come outside somewhere quiet so that I could give you my thoughts about that place, the Flaming Cow, which is located just across the River Thames Bridge over there. On the left hand side, you just gotta walk all over the bridge. Anyway,
my thoughts were as follows. It was busy. I got to sit at the bar type area in the middle because there wasn't any quieter spots by the window. But as far as the food was concerned, it was really nice. Probably the best beef I've tasted in Windsor for a long, long time. New restaurant, definitely worth checking out. I'd say that's probably a 9 out of 10, or 9.5 out of 10 maybe. Definitely worth going to. Probably my new favourite hangout if you did but know it. Good, okay, stay tuned and we'll have more. Sorry, there was one thing I forgot to mention whilst I was in there. Price. It's comparative to some of the other premium joints in Windsor. For instance, the Cattle Grid, it was around about the same price, at about 12 quid. But I think I enjoyed it a little bit more, and I would recommend people come and visit. So I'm standing opposite Windsor's Cookie House in the Guildhall. You can see them over my shoulder. Today we're going to try out some more beef. This time from here, the McDonald Hotel Scottish Steak Club, which is Windsor's premium steakhouse. So this is the venue in here. You can see there's dimmed lighting and lots of tables and chairs, some luxurious lamps, some bottles of wine on the wall there. Got myself kitted out with knives and forks and salt and pepper pots and water. And I'm looking forward to this. This is a little bit of a treat for me tonight, as I've been working quite hard over this weekend just gone. So I'm all settled in now, and my food's arrived. So I'll let you see what I've got. This is what you get for 15 quid.
So did you want to have
a good job
here, sir?
So far so good, thank you very much.
Thank you.
I'm looking forward to this. So I'm sitting here in the lobby, and I wanted to let you know how I felt my burger went down. Well done beef, really nicely cooked potato through thick cut chips. Waiter service. The only criticism I might have is there was a little bit too much mayo in the burger, and not enough ketchup to dip your chips in. Otherwise, reasonably priced at 15 quid, and very laid back atmosphere. I'm just sitting in the lobby now. Really nice in here. They do other things like steak and whatnot here in the steak club, but I guess you'll only see the steak if you decide to come in here yourself. Anyway, moving on. Right, so the next place I want to check out is this place behind me called Byron, where they do premium hamburgers, if you can see it there. It's right next to the McDonald's, which is just up there. But going to give this Byron place a go. Quick look at the menu in here. I'm probably going to go for the Byron. And some fries. See what comes out. Got some interesting decor on the walls in here. Refreshments resuscitate the weary traveller. Gonna look forward to this burger. So this is what's come out. Looks good. And chips. I'll let you know how I feel about it. So it's kind of quiet at the moment, no one's around, so I thought I'd give a quick review on it. Really nice. Byron, I think, is an established chain, so you'd expect for some good food from here. But yeah, no, very solid hamburger, very nice. Not really more I can say about it. I'll compare and contrast at the end, that's for sure. But yeah, no. You're not going to feel ripped off, I don't think, if you come here. So that cost me just over 12 quid. And as I said before, it wasn't bad. The opposite side of Windsor this evening, and we're going to try somewhere else out. A little restaurant called the Burger Stack. I don't know if you can see behind me, but I'm at the Windsor Arts Centre, or the old fire station as it was known. And the Burger Stack is literally just across the road over there. So we're going to give it a go, see how we get on. Alright, laters. So I've come home to show you the menu that they do at the Burger Stack, and it's open from 11 a.m. to 11 p.m. Link in the description below as to their website, and you can go and check out their menu there for yourself. But hopefully you can see here beef burgers, chicken burgers, veggie burgers. They do a range of stuff. I went for the Stack Classic Cheeseburger this evening, which cost me $7.95, which I didn't think was too bad price-wise. On the other side, you can see they do drinks in form of teas and coffees, milkshakes, and then freshly squeezed juices and smoothies. And they do a limited dessert menu, chocolate tort and lemon cheesecake for £4.95, none of which I partaked in.
come home this evening after visiting the Burger Stack to give you my final thoughts and review. Two reasons for this. Firstly, the restaurant, although it wasn't crowded, I felt the waiters and waitresses were on top of me a bit with, you know, is everything okay? And what would you like to drink, etc., etc. I just felt a bit stifled. That's you know, my own thing. Maybe I don't think it was too bad, in fairness, but I could have done it there, but then I'd have had a lot of questions as to why are you filming in our restaurant. So I think this is perhaps the better and safer option. Second reason is that it's the middle of February now and it's freezing cold outside. They're forecasting snow. So I just want to be home in the warm, if that makes any sense. So I'm fairly happy. Anyway, on to my review. I asked for the burger to be well done with no relish, and indeed it was. It was well done with no relish. You could probably see from the video that parts of the burger were flaking off a bit. Sort of breaking apart. So I don't know if that was poor quality beef, or whether it just wasn't kneaded together correctly, or what happened there. But taste-wise, it was perfectly acceptable. The chips were nice, curly, not curly fries, but they were sort of curved edge fries, which were nice. All in all, I'd say that's about 7.5 out of 10. It's not bad. Not a bad burger for the price at £7.95. You can go elsewhere in Windsor, pay a lot more, and not feel as happy as you would going there. It's not a bad burger. Good. Otherwise, no. I can recommend the Burger Stack. It's a good small restaurant. It's not over large or pretentious. The staff are friendly. The food is largely good. I just wouldn't say it's perfect. That's where I am with it. It's good, it's nice, it's at least 7 out of 10. But there are areas that I think it could improve. Like, I think if the beef was a bit, you know, it didn't break apart whilst you were eating the meal. And I think the onions as well, they were a bit undercooked. So, you know, there's other areas that they could improve. But otherwise, very good meal.